In this video, I'll teach you when and how to use local variables. Local variables are temporary variables that can only be accessed within the function that defines them. They are useful when you only need values within a particular expression. This is different from rule inputs, which allow you to pass data to other objects. Local variables have many uses in interfaces and expressions. You can use a local variable to store a user input that doesn't need to be stored elsewhere, like a search term. Or you may run into them if you're reusing a calculated value in multiple places in an expression. Local variables are also perfect for holding a temporary value until you can save it to a rule input to use elsewhere in your application. Let's look at this short expression that defines two local variables, one for the first name and one for the last name. You may see an expression like this one in any simple registration form. To get started, you'll first need the function abang_localVariables. This function allows you to define as many local variables as you need to use within an expression. All local variables must use the prefix localBang. Following the prefix is the name of the variable. It is best to keep the names short and descriptive. Once you add the values and your variables are defined, you can use them in your expressions. In this case, the output is the first and last name combined, Jane Smith. Because local variables can only be used within the expression they're defined in, you should generally have abang_localVariables at the top so that you can access and use it throughout your expression or interface. A local variable's type is determined by the value of the variable, unlike rule inputs, which have explicitly defined types. In this example, both localBang first name and localBang last name are of type text. Local variables are not limited to primitive data types. You can also use other types of variables or rules like rule inputs, expression rules, or process variables to define the value of your local variables. Here, the variable vehicle is defined using an expression rule that takes in a vehicle ID as a rule input. When you enter a valid vehicle ID, you get an output of the associated vehicle make and model. Local variables can also be defined without an initial value at all. Often, if your variable is used to store a temporary input, it will be defined without a value at first. In this example, the local variable answer does not have a default value. However, once the user selects either true or false, the variable is assigned the corresponding value. If you're using local variables in an interface, you may also need to consider their refresh behavior. By default, all variables defined within the localVariables function refresh when any referenced variables change. In this vehicle rental form, if the value of localBangBorrowedDate changes, then localBangReturnDate will automatically update by 7 days at the same time. You can change this default refresh behavior using the abangRefreshVariable function. We'll learn more about refresh behavior in another video. Now let's recap what you've learned so far. Local variables define and store temporary values within an expression. To define your local variables, you will need to use the function abang_localVariables. They can be defined with or without an initial value. These values refresh when any referenced variables change. You can use the refreshVariable function to modify this default behavior. To learn more about this function, visit Appian documentation or check out the interface courses at Academy Online. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.